President, my colleagues have said it. This is a clear indication of failure of systems. And Mr. President, the question that we should ask is that how do states gradually slide into failed state? If we look at some of the African states, such as Somalia, to some extent Sudan, Mali, Chad, and all of that, I look at the history of what took them to where they are today. Mr. President, it's no different from what we're experiencing in our country today. This banditry and kidnapping is commonplace in all parts of the country. When in Benue were experiencing this, in most places people thought that this was far-fetched. But sooner than later, it has spread to all nook and cranny of this country. So, Mr. President, as the Deputy Senate President did mention, I think we must call a spade a spade. This is a clear indication of failure of our security system. And it does appear to me as if we are also, as Nigerians or as elected representatives, seems to be condoning, because it's clear over the years, for the past 4 years, this has been very consistent. And the same security personnel who have failed woefully and totally to protect us. Mr. President, only yesterday we experienced something at our gate here. It's part of the same failure, because an institution such as this should be properly protected. And we are not protected. People are resorting to self-help. The situation we are inside will ultimately lead us to the situation that happened in Somalia. Because once individuals or communities begin to seek for self-help, you now begin to have warlords. Warlords leads to failure of a state. And I just could imagine with our population, if Nigeria becomes a failed state such as other states, Mr. President, you know the implication of that on the African continent. And so if there is any issue, this House, rather this Senate, must take seriously more than any other thing, is the issue of security and securing Nigerians. Because nobody is safe. You cannot travel on the road without, I don't think any of the senators here travel to their villages with all loads, truckloads of policemen and soldiers. That is not how it should be. We're in a democracy, we should move freely. We can't, not even in Abuja. Abuja, Mr. President, it will interest you to know that most of the airlines, foreign airlines, their staff no longer sleeps in Abuja. It's an embarrassment to this country that the capital of a federation as big as Nigeria, that you have foreign airlines are feeling safer outside Abuja than in Abuja. And this has permeated to all parts of the country. And so these two motions are motions that, outside of us just speaking here, because before I came to this House, I have listened to the 8th Assembly talked and discussed issues that are similar to what we are discussing here. And outside of talking, there has been no action. So if it is just talking about this, I don't think it's enough. I will go with the suggestion of the DSP that the security chiefs must, of urgency and necessity, be invited to this House. Let them come to this Senate, because we represent over 200 million Nigerians. And so we represent both the hopes, fears, and aspirations of Nigerians. And so we owe Nigerian an explanation. And so we have to invite the people who are saddled with this responsibility and are being paid by taxpayers' money to carry out this responsibility, which they have failed woefully. Let them come here and let us know, so that we have an explanation to at least give to the people that we represent and the people that send us here. Mr. President, without this, talking is not enough. You people have been talking here. I'm sure that you have, who have stayed here long enough, have listened to this numerous times. There's no action. We must begin to back up our talks with action. And the way to do it is to invite the security chiefs here and let them explain to us why the state of insecurity that have moved to the next level. I think as you people are moving to the next level, the state of insecurity...
Address the chair, please.
That we must address them beyond talking, as my Zamfara brother have said. Beyond, we've talked enough. Let us go into action, Mr. President.